Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Orleans Hotel and Casino, right here in the Fight Cup of the World, Las Vegas, Nevada, where tonight, Crown Boxing Incorporated, in association with the Orleans Hotel and Casino and Budweiser, is proud to present World Championship Boxing, a Friday night fights at the Orleans. Athletic Commission, the chairman is Dr. Tony Alamo. Our matchmaker this evening is Mr. Frank Luca. And now, fans, we head into our first bout of the evening as scheduled for four rounds in the super middleweight division. Scoring this bout will be Chuck Giampa, Bill Graham, and Dick Houck. And our referee in charge is Russell Mora. Introducing first, he'll be fighting out of the red corner. He entered the ring wearing black trimmed in white, and he weighed in at 161 pounds. His professional record stands at one victory with three defeats, one win by knockout. From Laughlin, Nevada, ladies and gentlemen, here is Richard Iron Horse Bingham. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner, he's wearing the solid red trunks, and he weighed in at 163 pounds. His professional record stands at one victory, only one defeat. He is making his home here in Las Vegas, Nevada. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Rodrigo, the Iceman Aguilar.
And everyone, welcome here to another installment of Crown Boxing and Frank Luca putting on a wonderful show for us here at the Orleans Hotel in Las Vegas, Nevada. It is Friday, April 27th, 2007, as we get ready to start the first bout of the evening, Rodrigo Aguilar versus Richard Bingham. And there's the bell to sound round number one. This is a super middleweight bout. Richard Bingham out of the red corner, and Aguilar boxing out of the blue corner, and some stiff boxing here. Nice jab by Bingham off the ropes here above the score, the timekeeper's table. And referee for this bout is Russell Mora. As the two pace themselves here in the center of the ring, getting themselves settled here as to the game plan and the fight plan, rather. Both boxers looking quite determined here. This is somewhat of a comeback bout for Richard Bingham. And there's a nice left jab up against the ropes by Aguilar as he's got Bingham now tied up, and referee Russell Mora looking on closely. A nice uppercut by Aguilar. A right hand over the top by Bingham. So as the two are tied up, Bingham lands a right to the body of Aguilar. Not much effect as a right overhand by Bingham. And there's a nice stiff left jab by Aguilar. Scores to the face of Bingham. And there's another a left hook by Aguilar. Scores to the head of Bingham as Russell Mora separates the boxes. We see some blood now forming out of the nose of Richard Bingham. And now another right hand by Bingham off the break as the two lock horns here in the center of the ring. And there's a nice right hand by Aguilar. Scores to the head of Bingham, and Bingham going to want to keep his hands up. There's a nice right hand by Bingham. Scores to the head of Aguilar as Russell Mora separates the action. Both boxers seeming a little flat on their feet. Somewhat surprising for it being only the first round of a four-round bout. Just the same, they are throwing their fists. I'd like to see Bingham throwing a little more, as he seems to be more content to cover his face and let Aguilar punch away here in round one. And as Bingham throws another right on the break, that's the third time of the bout, the
round comes to a close as both boxers go to their corners.
We're back on here as round two getting to begin. As I mentioned earlier, Richard Bingham coming off a 7-year layoff. He was in a bad car accident about 7 years ago. He had ruptured his spine. They had to cut out a herniation. He had some microdiscectomy done, and this has quite been an emotional road, to say the least, for Bingham, as it's his first fight back now in 7 years, and 35 years old, Richard Bingham, nicknamed the Iron Horse, trains at Performance Training Center and Top Rank here in Las Vegas. Aguiar, on the other hand, 28 years old, born in Norwalk, California, now lives and trains right here in Las Vegas. Nicknamed the Iceman. Let's see if he could bring the heat tonight here as round two now underway. Referee Russell Moore keeping a close watch on the action as Aguiar lunges forward with a right hand that misses. Russell Moore issuing a caution to Aguiar to keep his hands up, watch the low blow. As the two square away here at the center of the ring, and Aguiar throwing a right to the body, but again, he's doing much of the earmuff technique here as he's keeping his hands high, which is often good, but it's not intended to be a strategy throughout the fight. It's intended to protect one's head from punches that you can't see, and more importantly, punches that you can't see, but you're not going to score points just by keeping your hands in front of your head, as maybe Bingham is shaking off some cobwebs after a 7-year layoff here, but you're going to need to start throwing that leather if he wants to score some points, impress the judges, and of course win the bout. Aguiar been the busier boxer here for the entire bout as we get ready to see round two conclude. It's been much of the same as round one, with Aguiar being the busier boxer and Bingham covering up to protect himself but not throwing too much in return. Nice left hand by Aguiar over the top of Bingham's right hand, scores to his head, and nice left uppercut by Aguiar scores right through the guard of Bingham. And there's another right uppercut by Aguiar. A nice right hand over the top by Bingham scores. And now action picks up here in the far neutral corner as round two comes to a close. See a little more activity here from Richard Bingham in round number two at the end. Let's see if he could resume that pace in rounds three and four. There we go, folks. Round three underway here as referee Russell Mora, in between rounds, went to the corner of Richard Bingham and spoke to his trainer, John Vaughn, the cowboy, an eccentric fellow who actually wore spurs to the weigh-in last night and also trained by Willie Fields, and asked that their man, Richard Bingham, was ready to continue, and the answer was most certainly yes, as Aguiar really turning up the heat here, the Iceman, in round three. Bingham's face looking worse for wear here as he's pretty bloody and battered as round three is underway now. And there's a nice right hand over the top by Aguiar. Aguiar doing a good job of inboxing here, as I like to call it. He's keeping real close to Bingham while catching him with uppercuts through his guard and stepping off whenever he so chooses to land that overhand right. Bingham, in return, really just stands there with his hands over his face, trying to protect against the onslaught by Aguiar, but again, not throwing much leather in return. It's clearly going to be down on the scorecards. And about the halfway point of round number three, as action pretty much slows back to the pace it was at through rounds one and two. Sans the end of round two, of course, when we had a short burst of action towards the neutral corner. And there's a nice uppercut by Bingham, scores and knocks back the head of Aguiar. And now blood all over the back and head of Aguiar. Most certainly the blood of Richard Bingham. Bingham, incidentally, valets cars at the Flamingo Hotel when he's not boxing. There's a nice strong uppercut, it seemed, by Aguiar. And now a nice left by Bingham. Snaps back the head of Aguiar. And nice right hand by Bingham with a right counter by Aguiar to send Bingham back. And as you hear it from the crowd here, the capacity crowd at the Orleans Hotel, Crown Boxing putting on quite a show here tonight, as round one, rather bout one, seems to be somewhat of a blood fest here, as Richard Bingham taking a lot of abuse. And now referee Russell Moore are going to separate the boxes and issue a warning to Aguiar as action resumes here in the center of the ring. Tonight's broadcast brought to you by RASP.TV. Webcasting, live streaming on the internet. And as we get ready to end round three, we see a bloody and battered Richard Bingham going back to his corner for one more round. This is a four-round bout, folks. Stay tuned.
Ladies and gentlemen, this will be the fourth and final round. A round of applause, please, for Richard Bingham and Rodrigo Aguiar.
And here we go, folks. The fourth and final round here between Rodrigo Aguiar and Richard Bingham. It's been a pretty decent bout so far through rounds one and three, as we've seen Aguiar, the more busy fighter, rather the busier fighter, through rounds one through three. And there's a nice right hand by Bingham, as referee Russell Morris separates the boxes. Rodrigo Aguiar, trained by Big Bam. Richard Bingham, the Iron Hoss, hopes to open up a boxing gym, home of the Thoroughbreds. And as we are underway here, well into round number four, we see much of the same defensive stance and posture that Bingham has executed much of the night, which is flat feet, keeping his hands up by his head, but not really throwing too much. He hasn't quite gotten off yet this entire bout. And there's a nice right hand by Aguiar, certainly the busier boxer here, as he scores again to the head of Bingham. And nice left hand by Aguiar. Russell Mora looking closely as action is near the far side of the ring. Aguiar trying to get his man up against the ropes where he could hopefully do some more damage. Corner of Aguiar asking him to let his hands go. And there's that right to the body by Bingham. Not much effect. And it looks like that's it, folks, here in the middle of the fourth and final round, and the corner of Richard Bingham. His trainer, John Vaughn, a cowboy, throws in the towel to spare his man any further abuse at the hands of the game, Rodrigo Aguiar. And Richard Bingham retires the bout here at 152 of the fourth.